All right, so I climbed down the equipment. So that's spool assembly. Here's the unit here. And the spool assembly is in there. A whole bunch of them, right? The pilot lines that I was referring to, the second one, is this guy. Oh God, you can't see it, but where my finger is, it's right there. Right there, it's that guy. Right there. In the back of that main monster valve body set. So, why am I making such a big deal out of it? So we got two pilot lines. That pilot line right there feeds into this is the upper variable displacement axial pump, right? That's that pilot line. And the one that I showed you earlier is this pilot line, and it feeds into the lower variable displacement pump. Okay. But these two pilot lines are not part of the pilot control system. And the pilot control system runs off a separate, smaller pilot pump, which is bolted onto this lower pump right here, back here. And this guy basically sends pilot signals everywhere, which is those upper hose is there, controlling all the different cylinders. Cylinder up, cylinder down, bucket open, knuckle open, grab a log, scoop a dirt, pivot the deck, that sort of thing. But that pilot system runs up to 460 PSI. And it has this valve body here, which changes the different signals depending on what the jobs are and that sort of thing. And that's controlled. You've got some sensors here that will control the pilot signal. But it's confusing because folks that work on these things have access to CAT ET software, and that software controls a lot more. This unit has zero access to CAT ET. It's built in Japan, and it does not use any sort of electronic solenoids controlling the main output lines here and here. It's all done through balancing. And what they do is they sample the pressure need out of that unit there, and you've got an internal pilot signal that these two pumps share, right? And then you've got your pilot lines that are not part of your pilot system there, but a separate bleed system that go here and here, the two lines I was making a big deal earlier. And basically what happens is if the need increases, the whole system will destroke the axial pump, which increases the pressure. It decreases volume, so you can't move as fast, but you increase pressure. And it's a balancing act between need versus demand. And it's done without any kind of electronics. And it's looking like, originally I thought it was this pilot line here that was broken because of the spring pressure relief inside that valve body up there. But now I'm actually thinking the actual pump is broken, the obvious answer. Okay, so what am I gonna do? I've done another test earlier where it shows that this pilot signal is not destroking, whereas this pilot signal here is destroking. And I did it with these gauges, right? But to make 100% sure that the problem is actually not up there, but here, I'm actually going to block these guys off. there is a pressure relief for each of these pilot circuits, so I'm not going to blow any lines up or anything. And then I'm going to check the pressures and make sure that they are equal. I'm going to use a digital gauge, but right now I'm just going to use a sloppy 5,000 PSI gauge because I don't actually know where the pressure relief is set on these from the factory in Japan. So once I confirm that they're between 500 and 800 PSI, I'll switch to a more sensitive gauge. But that's going to be the first test. I'm going to assume, now I'm hoping that these two pressures, once they're capped for these pilot lines, pilot line one, pilot line two, once these guys are capped, I'm gonna walk out here and we're gonna have equal pressure around 500 to 600 PSI. Once that's the case,